the International Convention on Standards of Training, Certification and Watchkeeping for Seafarers, 1978 sets qualification standards for masters, officers and watch personnel on seagoing merchant ships. STCW was adopted in 1978 by conference at the International Maritime Organization in London, and entered into force in 1984. The convention was significantly amended in 1995. The 1978 STCW convention was the first to establish basic requirements on training, certification and watchkeeping for seafarers on an international level. Previously, the standards of training, certification and watchkeeping of officers and ratings were established by individual governments, usually without reference to practices in other countries. As a result, standards and procedures varied widely, even though shipping is extremely international by nature. The convention prescribes minimum standards relating to training, certification and watchkeeping for seafarers which countries are obliged to meet or exceed. The convention did not deal with manning levels. IMO provisions in this area are covered by Regulation 14 of Chapter 5 of the International Convention for the Safety of Life at Sea, 1974, whose requirements are backed up by Resolution A890-21, Principles of Safe Manning, adopted by the IMO Assembly in 1999, which replaced an earlier Resolution A481-12, adopted in 1981. One especially important feature of the convention is that it applies to ships of non-party states when visiting ports of states which are parties to the convention. Article X requires parties to apply the control measures to ships of all flags to the extent necessary to ensure that no more favorable treatment is given to ships entitled to fly the flag of a state which is not a party than is given to ships entitled to fly the flag of a state that is a party. The difficulties which could arise for ships of states which are not parties to the convention is one reason why the convention has received such wide acceptance. By 2014, the STCW convention had 158 parties, representing 98.8% of world shipping tonnage. 1995 revision. On July 7, 1995, the IMO adopted a comprehensive revision of STCW. It also included a proposal to develop a new STCW code, which would contain the technical details associated with provisions of the convention. The amendments entered force on February 1, 1997. Full implementation was required by February 1, 2002. Mariners already holding licenses had the option to renew those licenses in accordance with the old rules of the 1978 convention during the period ending on February 1, 2002. Mariners entering training programs after August 1, 1998 are required to meet the competency standards of the new 1995 amendments. The most significant amendments concerned: A. Enhancement of port state control. B. Communication of information to IMO to allow for mutual oversight and consistency in application of standards. C. Quality standard systems, oversight of training, assessment, and certification procedures. The amendments require that seafarers be provided with familiarization training, and basic safety training, which includes fire prevention and firefighting, elementary first aid, personal survival techniques, and personal safety and social responsibility. This training is intended to ensure that seafarers are aware of the hazards of working on a vessel and can respond appropriately in an emergency. D. Placement of responsibility on parties, including those issuing licenses, and flag states employing foreign nationals, to ensure seafarers meet objective standards of competence, and E. Rest period requirements for watchkeeping personnel. Manila Amendments, the IMO Convention on Standards of Training, Certification and Watchkeeping of Seafarers adopted a new set of amendments in Manila in 2010 called the Manila Amendments. These amendments were necessary to keep training standards in line with new technological and operational requirements that require new shipboard competencies. The Manila Amendments were effective as of January 1, 2012. There is a transition period until 2017 when all seafarers must be certified and trained according to the new standards. Implementation is progressive. Every year a modified set of requirements comes into force. The most significant amendments are: new rest hours for seafarers, new grades of certificates of competence for able seamen in both deck and engine, new and updated training, refreshing requirements, mandatory security training, additional medical standards, specific alcohol limits in blood or breath. STCWF Convention, on July 7, 1995, the International Convention on Standards of Training, Certification and Watchkeeping for Fishing Vessel Personnel was adopted as a separate treaty as part of the comprehensive revisions to STCW. It applies the principles of STCW to fishing vessels from ratifying states that are 24 meters in length and above. STCWF came into force on September 29, 2012. Notes. References. IMO information regarding STCW. U.S. Coast Guard information regarding STCW.